Sweeping is the second step in the major garbage collection cycle. In the second step, either sweep or compact process happens. We will discuss the former in this video. Hi, I am Rohan, and this video is part of a series of videos where we are exploring how JS manages its memory in depth. So let's get to it. The sweeping phase is part of the V8's garbage collection process. After the marking process is complete, the reachable or the live objects are marked. After that, the sweeping phase is responsible for reclaiming the memory occupied by the dead or the unreachable objects. In this phase, V8 iterates over the marking bitmap of each page in the heap to find ranges of unmarked objects. These are portions in memory that are occupied by objects that are no longer reachable from any routes and are therefore can be considered as garbage. For each range of unmarked objects found, the space is added to a list of free regions within the page. Let's look at the flow of the sweep algorithm. So each heap space is swept one by one in a particular order by calling the sweep space function. In sweep space function, within the space, each page is iterated, and within a particular page, each object is iterated. When we iterate through each object, we check if an object is marked or not, meaning that the marked bits of the objects are set to black. If it is, we clear it by setting the marked bits to white. Otherwise, we deallocate the object by assigning its reference to the respective free list. We will get to that in a moment. Anyway, this process is repeated until we iterate through all the objects and free the unreachable ones. This function is called for all the spaces in the heap in a particular order. So it starts with large object space, then old pointer space, then old data space, code space, cell space, new space, and finally map space. The map space is swept last because deallocating dead maps overrides them, and the unreachable objects in other spaces may rely on these dead maps for their exact sizes. So after all the spaces are swept, we resume our main process and wait for the next sweep cycle. Instead of sweeping the entire heap all at once, which can cause noticeable pauses in our main application, V8 performs lazy sweeping. This means that the heap is swept in smaller pieces over time. Basically, the sweeping process is divided into smaller tasks that are performed in between the main script execution. This approach interleaves the sweeping process in between the main code's execution, ensuring that the work of sweeping is spread over time and the main process thread is not paused for long periods of time. This enhances the application's responsiveness and performance by minimizing the impact of garbage collection on the execution flow. This balances the necessity of garbage collection with the application's performance needs, providing a smooth and responsive user experience. Throughout the video, I have mentioned allocation and deallocation of objects. But how does V8 accomplishes this? The sweep phase of the V8's garbage collection process involves scanning the heap for dead objects and adding them to a data structure known as a free list. The free list is essentially a record of memory locations in the heap that are available for writing new object data. This free list is then used to allocate new objects in the future. Each page has its own separate free lists, which are further categorized into small, medium, and large regions, depending on the size of the objects that they can accommodate. These regions are defined by their size in words. Smaller regions have less than 256 words, medium regions have less than 2048 words, and larger regions have less than 16,384 words. Now, what are words? I will leave it to you to find out because it's getting out of scope. But typically, each word is around 32 bits or 64 bits depending on the memory architecture. Anyway, the free lists are used for several scenarios. Of course, they are used to allocate new objects whenever we need them. But apart from that, they are used during scavenge operation. During scavenge operation, the objects that have survived are moved from the new space to the old space. The free lists in the old space are used to identify where there is enough space to accommodate these promoted objects. Also, during the process of heap compaction, which is done to mitigate memory fragmentations, objects might need to be moved or relocated. Again, free lists are used to find suitable new locations for these objects. So, to quickly summarize, we discussed sweeping process, we looked at the sweeping algorithm in detail, and we also discussed ways to improve this process using lazy sweeping. After that, we discussed what free lists are and how it is utilized. I also want to discuss the compact process in detail. So this is what we will discuss in the upcoming video. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Namaskar.